Good morning. This is Harshit, your tech host for today, and welcome to today's Tech News Bulletin brought to you by IT Voice. Click the subscribe button to stay updated. Tesla, led by Elon Musk, has put forward a proposal to build a battery storage factory in India and is seeking incentives from Indian officials. The company has been in discussions about establishing an electric vehicle EV factory in India, targeting EVs priced at approximately $24,000. Tesla's Powerwall system, capable of storing power from solar panels or the grid, could receive support through subsidies. While both Tesla and the Indian government express interest in the proposal, its realization remains uncertain. Next up, we have semiconductor equipment manufacturer Cohu has successfully consolidated its operations onto a single cloud platform for enterprise resource planning, ERP, and supply chain management using Oracle Cloud ERP financial applications. This transformation initiative began in 2018 and was completed in February 2020, replacing legacy systems like SAP, Glovia, and Cispro. Cohu's objective was to establish a flexible foundation for future acquisitions, leveraging Oracle's next-generation data analytics and AI platform to enhance decision-making. Cisco Systems has entered into an agreement to acquire cybersecurity firm Splunk for $28 billion, marking its largest ever deal. The acquisition aims to strengthen Cisco's software business and capitalize on the growing use of artificial intelligence. The deal has received unanimous approval from both Cisco and Splunk boards and is expected to close by the end of the third quarter of 2024, subject to regulatory approvals. A termination fee of $1.48 billion is payable by Cisco if the deal is cancelled. The transaction positions Cisco and Splunk as one of the world's largest software companies and accelerates Cisco's shift towards a more recurring revenue-based business model. Zomato has launched a new feature called Tips for the Kitchen Staff on its platform, enabling customers to tip kitchen staff when rating their orders with 4 or 5 stars. Unlike tipping delivery agents, this feature allows users to tip kitchen staff as a percentage of their order value or an amount of their choice. Zomato plans to pass the entire tip amount to the restaurant without deductions, apart from any required taxes. The feature acknowledges the dedication of chefs, cleaning staff, and kitchen helpers. To access this feature, users can visit the live order tracking page after placing an order on the Zomato platform. Meta, the parent company of WhatsApp and Instagram, has started rehiring some employees who were previously laid off over the past year. The move is part of efforts to boost employee morale after a year marked by layoffs and cost-cutting measures. Meta has reintroduced pre-pandemic perks, including branded t-shirts for employees, reopening most of the company's Menlo Park, California office restaurants, and adjusting dinner timings. Other perks such as laundry service, haircuts, Thursday happy hours, and food stalls have also made a comeback. Despite the revival of office perks, some employees have noted that benefits are not as generous as they used to be, with laundry service now being a paid offering. Cummins. India is prioritizing sustainability by ensuring its products meet the CPCB-IV plus emission norms, effective since 1 July for diesel gensets. The company's power systems team introduced CPCB-IV plus compliant gensets, representing a significant step in emissions reduction. The CPCB-IV plus norms are among the most stringent emission standards for power generation engines. Cummins India achieved a 90% reduction in particulate matter and harmful nitrogen oxides emissions from genset exhaust compared to the earlier CPCB-2 norms. Sustainability is considered essential for long-term success, growth, and business resilience, reflecting Cummins India's commitment to addressing climate change. At last, the Indian Space Research Organization ISRO is preparing to reactivate the Vikram lander and Pragyan rover on the moon. The lander and rover were designed with a mission life of just 14 Earth days from the landing date, 24 August. To protect against the moon's extremely cold nighttime temperatures, ISRO decided to put the vehicles to sleep after achieving their main objectives. The revival attempts are set to begin with the hope that the lander and rover, if functional, can continue operating for another 14 Earth days. ISRO also moved the lander to a new location before the shutdown, potentially offering fresh perspective if reactivated successfully. This is Harshit signing off. Stay tuned and follow IT Voice for the latest tech news.
स्कैम 2003 जैसे हर्षद मेहता का स्कैम था, इस सीरीज के बारे में बात करते हैं जिसमें अब्दुल करीम तेलगी की पूरी ये सीरीज है। सीरीज से हमें पता चलता है कैसे एक फ्रूट सेलर बना है इंडिया का सबसे बड़ा स्कैमर। उसने फ्रूट सेलिंग का काम बंद कर दिया और वो मुंबई चला गया। मुंबई में उसने ट्रैवल एजेंसी खोली और वो लोगों को कल भेजता था। ये चीज बहुत जल्दी पुलिस के सामने आ गई और उसे जेल में डाल दिया गया। उसकी वहां पे मुलाकात हुई राम रतन सोनी से। उसने आइडिया दिया स्टैम्प पेपर के स्कैम के बारे में, बताया कि ये फैक्ट्री, आप इस फैक्ट्री को ले लोगे तो यहाँ पे आप इतने सारे प्रोडक्शन हाउस बना सकते हो। पूरे 30,000 करोड़ का स्कैम कर दिया। ये 30,000 करोड़ का स्कैम है, जब ये सामने आया तो 2001 में इनको जेल हो गई। इनकी जेल होने के बाद 2017 तक ये जेल के अंदर थे, उनकी डेथ हो गई वहाँ पे और ये सीरीज बाहर आ गई। तो आपको भी कैसी लगी सीरीज जरूर कमेंट करके बताइएगा। जिन लोगों को स्कैम 2003 के बारे में शॉर्ट में जानना है तो इस वीडियो उनके साथ जरूर शेयर करिएगा। मिलते हैं नए वीडियो के साथ। फॉलो आईटी शॉर्ट्स फॉर मोर।